Hello, everybody. Welcome to the stream this evening. My name is David Needham, or you can call me by my Twitter handle, Unreal Nighthawk. Hello. This is my first stream on YouTube. It's a little strange, but I'm giving it a try after a bunch of other streamers from Twitch have started talking more and more about YouTube and the differences between Twitch and YouTube, and I figured, you know, why not give it a shot? I haven't been streaming on Twitch as much lately anyway, so very little to lose by trying, seeing what it's like, seeing how much friction there might be to get it set up, and who knows, maybe discover some benefits to using YouTube instead of Twitch. So if this is your first time here, welcome. If this is your first time on the channel, you know, of course, the like insert obligatory sort of YouTube thing, you know, give us a subscription, like this video if you want to support the stream, and all that fun stuff. Ultimately, I play games for me. I play games for fun. If you're here and enjoying the stream, that's great too. I hope you'll participate in the chat, hang out with me for a little while, and have some fun as we play West of Loathing. Now, I started this game last week, a week ago today, over on Twitch. I'll be uploading the video very soon. It should be there, probably by the time you're watching this, if you are watching the video later, if this is not live. But West of Loathing is a RPG based around the Kingdom of Loathing sort of metaverse, I guess you could say. It's a game where there's lots and lots of dad jokes. Not quite exactly dad jokes, but more or less dad jokes. Great humor that I appreciate very, very much. It's a absolutely hilarious game that is so much fun to play. It hasn't been very difficult yet. I think it might be possible to boost up the difficulty for the next playthrough. But for this playthrough, I'm content just to enjoy all the jokes and the story and kind of see what there is to get from it. This is a game that you are intended to play through multiple times. I'm still in the first playthrough. I got, let's see, maybe 3 hours in last time, and I'll be able to get in a couple more hours tonight here on this channel. So be sure to check back in the stream or the channel if you'd like to see the first episode. But yeah, without further ado, we can jump on and we have our character here, Felix Cassidy, who we're going to be playing with. Now, the fine details of this game are just things to be impressed by. So like, for example, this is the title screen, right? When you click on things, you get that excellent sort of bullet sound, right? But you can actually interact with things, like shoot that bottle, let's shoot that tumbleweed, let's shoot the can of beans a few times, and then after a bit, it will blow up in beans. Little things like that are very subtle. But, man, do I appreciate that. It's just so cool. So we've been playing for a while, so let's go ahead and just continue, and we'll pick up from here. Alright, so this is our character. Man, we have the funny walks enabled right now. I think I'm just going to start by turning that off. Stupid walking. It was fun for a little bit last time, but I think I'm good. Our currency in this game is meat. So you can see up here we currently have 388 meat. This is our partner here. Our partner, I should say. What's his name? Pete? Sneaky Pete? He's a miner, basically. Well now, there seems to be a fun little mine. Not too deep, not too cramped. Shame it seems to have run dry. You can do that just by looking around out here. Oh, I got plenty of experience in these matters. And then we can talk to them. I think I've already been through all this already. This is our horse. It's a crazy horse named Lethal Juice because of a someone who raided the stream last time over on Twitch. Lethal Juice raided the stream, so we named the crazy horse after Lethal Juice. I don't know, could you hear the horse talking to us? Oh man. Okay, well anyway, we are ready to kind of go out and complete some missions. We have done the Snake Pit Mine. It's pretty much done now. Way back here, we did the Desert House earlier too, and Dirtwater is the town. Before we return to Dirtwater, I think it's good for us to kind of go up and complete some of these other missions. So let's go check out the Cavern Canyon. As you're riding toward your destination, a flock of color catches your eye. You parallel park your horse and stop to investigate the source. It's one of those cacti with a rainbow-colored buttons on it. Oh, I don't have Forgin, so I can't collect them, unfortunately. So I guess I have to leave it alone. That's a bummer. Danger spider. A danger spider, eh? I am angry. I got this anger here with the extra the boost because I stared in the mirror and insulted myself back at the base. I have tons of inventory, lots of little things I can do, and you'll need these for various things. They can also like boost your HP or whatnot, but honestly, they might come in handy for things, and it's hard to know what you're going to need before it comes up. It is possible also to not be able to complete a particular thing because you didn't do it in the right order, or you don't have the item or the skill at that point. And that's okay. Like I said, you're intended to play the game more than once, so you're supposed to know, like, oh, next time I need to do this thing first, and then I can come back through and I'll have what I need. So, we have some things equipped. The Barely Enchanted Hat is giving us some stuff. Replica Sheriff Badge. The Desert Gang Six Gum. Pickaxe. A Filthy Porcelain Cow, which appears to be upside down. A Nasty Ring. I think both of these we actually got out of spittoons at different saloons that we visited. And we are currently wearing no pants and no boots. So hopefully those are things that we can get figured out. I think it's time to enter the cave. Medicine? This crate of medicine scrawled on it in black paint. I'm skeptical. A little sus, but I'm going to open it up anyway. Oh no, it is! Bottle of laudanum. And an army field trauma kit. You hear the sudden chittering coming from that big hole behind you. Uh-oh. I see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 eyes? No, more than that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 14 eyes. Okay, so maybe we should prioritize what we open. Let's open the weapons next. You should leave right now before that spider eats you. Oh. Well, I mean, okay, I guess. No way you're going back in there. Hey, why not, though? I can take it. I can totally take that spider. This cave door has been boarded up. Let's pry off the boards. These boards can't hide from your prying eyes or your prying crowbar. Danger spider. And this is sort of a game also where you kind of want to click on everything because you never really know what might be handy. Ooh. Is that... This is... Wait, what am I doing? You can see the gang on the other side of this big pile of junk, but you're not going to be able to get to them from this end. Maybe if you had more legs, you'd be able to pick your way through it. Oh. So... I'm going to be a spider, perhaps? It's weird that I'm sneaking. I don't think I've seen that animation before. Also, I realized my screen. I'm actually... It's cutting off the bottom of my screen a little bit. And I'm not sure why. I don't think there's anything I can do about that either, unfortunately. There are very few options that I can pick from, but let's see, video options. Let me see if I can make it just a little bit smaller, perhaps. That one? Yeah, okay, so I can see the bottom of my screen. I can see in the streaming, like an OBS over there, I can see that it's also, like, you get the more black border around things. However, I get the feeling it's not going to make a difference. Oh no, totally, you can see the bottom now. Huh, okay, well, I guess that's fine. This door has, like, 15 deadbolts on it. The note tacked to it says, please don't open this door unless you want to get eaten by a giant spider. Even then, don't open it, because the rest of us don't want to get eaten by the spider. It isn't even signed, so you can hardly be expected to take it seriously. Open the door! The tunnel behind this opening goes straight up. There's no way to get through unless you're a huge spider. Oh. Okay, well, again, kind of feel like maybe I'm supposed to be a spider somehow. Weird. Oh, I need to sneak out. I need to, like, leave through the entrance over here. Yeah. Oh, there's another one. What? I have no idea that from the, I hit the cactus. A coffee cactus? Let's try to go in, I can't go in there. What if I talk to my partner? Danger spider! I tell you what, boss, you go on ahead. I better stay here and keep an eye on the horse. What's the matter, Pete? Scared of spiders? A spider fearsome enough a spider fearsome enough that some feller came along and put up a danger spider sign. That there seems to be a perfectly reasonable spider to be scared of. Okay, you have a point there. What do you think we should do next? Well, now, if you're in a hurry to push west, I say a train will get us there. I'm looking to complete this quest, man. I can't go in there, apparently. There's nothing to do in here, apparently. So I think I just have to go in and fight the dudes if they're in this side. You hear horrible skittering noises followed by a scream. Oh, you know what? I let loose the spider who went in and just ate the bad guys. You hear a horrible skittering noise, followed by a scream, followed by more horrible skittering noises, followed by more screams, followed by some rapping noises, followed by some muffled screams. Then there's more skittering, then silence. Yeah, let's go inside. I think it's safe. The gang has been prepped for spider consumption. Arrest them! Not yet. I want to check and see if there's any loot. Danger kitchen. Ooh, what's this? Danger bar? What? This place looks like it could use a new bartender. He had a jaw harp in his pocket. Maybe they killed him for playing the jaw harp too much. Ooh. I can sell it. Can I actually, like, equip it or anything, though? Let's see. Jaw harp. I can plunk it. I don't know if you can hear it, but it's twanging. You can stick the twanger in your mouth and plunk it the best you can. Plunk it some more. You plunk your twanger and then you plunk it some more. Do it more. You plunk your twanger with vigor. I'm just gonna keep going. Maybe there's something at the end, because if you remember from the previous stream, there's a bookcase, and if you keep looking, like, you just keep looking and keep looking and keep looking, eventually you get something, but it seems to be repeating, so I think that that's probably all you can do, unfortunately. Alright, well, hey, can I, all these bottles are empty. Oh, man. Can I do anything? There are a few bottles left on the shelf. Let's take them. Cheap whiskey, cheap tequila, cheap wine. All these bottles are empty, though. Yeah, okay. I guess that's it. Doesn't look like there's anything else I can do in here at the danger bar. So let's go in the danger kitchen. Ooh, there's somebody in here. Hey dude, this poor chef is chained to the wall, his eyes widen as you approach. Hey, you're not one of them. Are you here to rescue me? Let me get back to you on that one. Sure. Oh, thank goodness. He thrusts his hand into yours and shakes vigorously. I'm Doug. Felix, how you doing, Doug? Well, I've been chained up to this dank cave for weeks, cooking for these stripy-hatted idiots. That sounds awful. You wanna know the worst part? There's a perfectly good oven 8 feet to my right, and a shelf of perfectly good ingredients 8 feet to my left. How's that the worst part? This chain's only 4 feet long. Ugh. I know, right? There I was, fresh out of culinary school, with a million meat idea in my head. Remember, meat is currency, so... and now here I am, 4 feet shy of my dreams, cooking the same pot of soup over and over again. What million meat idea? You, promised not to steal my idea? I mean, I really can't promise anything, if I'm honest. I really can't promise anything. He frowns. Well, I'm not gonna tell you my idea. Yeah, that might have been the wrong choice. Oh, suit yourself. So I'm gonna leave him because he's telling me. Wait a minute, you can't leave me here? Come on, promise me you won't steal my idea so we can get on with this. I mean, I could say no can do. I'm kind of curious now, if I keep pushing it, what'll happen. No can do. Sheesh, for all the heroes in the West, and I got you. Just go. I'll wait for somebody who isn't an unscrupulous intellectual property thief. Relent. You know, I'm gonna leave him. And we're gonna see if I can circle back after I maybe loot some stuff from the room. Is there anything I can take out of here? Surprisingly, it doesn't look like it. Nothing on the shelf looks good. What over here? Nothing there either. Oh man, can I talk to him now? He looks up at you. Oh, you're back. Let's try this again. Do Do you promise you won't steal my idea? No. Ridiculous. Let's try again. Yes, I promise. Okay then, it's a new kind of sandwich, maybe a taco. It's so revolutionary that I'm not quite sure where it fits in the whole hand food taxonomy, to be honest. Anyway, in the middle of it, there's a sausage, but it's sausage made from the cheapest possible parts of a pig, ground up so finely that you can't identify them anymore. I mean, that sounds vaguely familiar. Okay. It's served in a long split roll, which soaks up the grease, so you can't tell how fatty the sausage is. The best part, the name. You ready to hear the name? I call it the Hot Dug. What do you think? How about the Hot Felix instead? Don't be ridiculous. Hot Felix. What does that even mean? Ridiculous. Hey, there's no need to be mean about it. Not that any of this even matters. Even if I did get off this chain, there's no point in hanging around this empty cave making hot dogs for myself. I don't even like the taste of them. You could set up a shop in Dirtwater. Hey, it's not a bad idea. You're a genius, Felix. Hot dogs for sale, all day, every day. I'll make a mint. Say, there's an idea. What if I added mint to the sausage mixture? You help him break the chains, he leaves the cave, hauling the oven and the shelf full of ingredients, muttering himself about new sausage recipes. Cool. I mean, that's pretty cool. But I'm really surprised I can't, like, get anything, but I guess there's nothing really good to get. Oh well. We rescued Doug. I guess it's time to, you know, actually, I want to go see... You can't get past this pile of junk without hurting yourself. Okay. I want to go see if I can talk to the spider now. Maybe not talk to the spider, but, like, can I do anything with the spider before it fast travels me to the town? No way you're going back in there. Okay, well, what about in here? Is there anything to see in here now? No? Apparently not. And still no point in going through here. So, looks like I'm just not supposed to do this. I guess I'll just go arrest the bad guys all wrapped up in the web. Arrest them! You stack the cocoons on the back of your horse, except for one, which Pete pushes all the way back to town in a wheelbarrow he found somewhere, and head to the Dirtwater Jail. Is that the Stripey Hat Gang? What happened to them? They had a run-in with a giant spider. Giant spider of justice. Fortunately, the reward is for results rather than explanations. 1,000 meat and 30 XP. I will take it. Thank you. Groovy. The Stripey Hat Gang cell. Cool. Howdy, what can I do for you? Give her what's left of the Desert House Gang. This is certainly a bag of severed ears and teeth and such. Which gang is this? The House in the Desert Gang. I'll take your word for it. Good job. Thanks a bundle. Unfortunately, they're not going to be in their cells, though. So, yeah, that's too bad. You know, an empty cell. I think there's an achievement or something for having, like, all the cells filled up. And so, unfortunately, we're not going to get that one because we, like, blew up the bad guys. The first one there. So, oh well. No biggie. Oh, hey, it's Hot Dog, not Hot Doug. Howdy, Doug. Well, if it isn't my savior, good old Felix. Howdy yourself. The sign outside, yeah, I had to change the name. I tried to file a trademark, and it turns out there's already something called a Hot Doug. Trust me, you don't want to know. I wish I didn't know. Anyway, a single letter removed, and I'm in business. He gestures at the menu in the wall behind him. I feel obligated to buy something, although honestly, he should give it to me for free. I could buy an elegant hot dog, a jumbo hot dog, or a saucy hot dog. Seriously though, it's worth 10, he's charging me 100, he should really give me a little bit of extra discount on that, I think. I think it'd be the nice thing to do, but oh well. Not interested at this moment. Thank you, Doug. Good luck. I think I'm gonna head on out. Or, I'm gonna mosey on out of here. Since we're here, we may as well go check on the post office, or the post device, and see if we have any letters Any mail for me? Nope. Alright. Guess not. And, whoa, dude, what's up? He's in a lot of pain. You okay, buddy? I'm pretty sure my leg is broken, so, nope. What happened? Traffic accident? No, it just sort of broke all of a sudden. I guess I don't get enough vitamins or whatever. Good nutrition can be difficult in this day and age. I'm gonna need some medicine for this. Can you help me? Sure. Thank you. There's a mission up north. The nuns there run a little hospital and sell medical supplies. Can you get me some broken leg pills? Yeah, I mean, that's how it works, right? Pretty sure that works out. Pretty sure that's exactly how it's supposed to go. Yeah, not really much else for us to do here. I'm still angry, so I don't need to, like, go re-up my status effects. So let's on head out. Let's see if we can go check out one of those two missions. Oh man, that one's way up there. Wow, that's really far away. Well, we've done the Cavern Canyon, so let's go down to Fort Cowardice now. You happen across an abandoned crate, which apparently fell off a wagon or something since the lid had been knocked loose. You know what that means. You fish through the crate and help yourself to the contents, which appear to be mining gear. So you were even more right than you knew. It's mine. Ha, I get it. I got some dynamite and a can of kerosene. Sweet! Alright. Got some cannons. Just like the old saying goes, when life gives you cannons, make a cannonade. Anything I can do with this sign? Doesn't look like it. Let's go in. Hey Pete, you know anything? Sure do look abandoned. I'd say here and keep an eye out. I'll stay here and keep an eye out while you check out the place. Might be good some good scavenging. Can I climb? Climb up the ladder to the watchtower and look around. Nice view from up here. Ooh, I have binoculars. You see a horse apple big enough to see from here. You discover a new map location, the Big Apple. You climb down from the watchtower and pitch binoculars in the nearby trash can. Hey, what? That's not cool. That's not cool. I don't want to pitch them in a trash can. I might need those later. I guess let's just, medical tent, busted, okay, let's get this cannonball. I got a demi-culverin cannonball. Good thing there's no weight on, any of this stuff. It's a cannonball made to fit a demi-culverin, a cannon with a bore diameter of 10 centimeters, not a demi-less or demi-more. Great. I can use kerosene on enemies, apparently. That's good to know. And then what's this? This mishap definitely got somebody fired. Ooh. Yep. This sign has the goblin word for toilet on it. Goblin, eh? The sign says toilet and goblin, which means it makes it seem pretty likely that goblins use this tent as a toilet. There's no way you're gonna go in there. Yeah, okay. What's this? Seems like there's supposed to be something on the side there, but I guess not. Okay. What about this one? This must be the math tent. Yes, this must be the math tent. Oh boy. This cot is soaked with blood. Based on the papers and anatomical diagrams scattered across the surface, you're guessing this desk belongs to Fort Cowardice's nurse. The papers are mostly boring medical records, dental daguerreotypes, lamentations, and antibiotics that haven't been discovered yet. It's that kind of thing. Hey, wait up, it's this. You look at it, it might be important. Marching orders. This is a set of army marching orders from before all the army's marching orders were march back east as fast as your lily-livered little yellow-bellied feet can go, you damnable cowards. Okay. Look at the diagrams. Just a bunch of disgusting drawings of sliced open bodies. Okay. This shelf has some unlooted medical supplies on it. Well, yeah. Army field trauma kit and military-grade whiskey. Nice. A safe? The safe labeled controlled substances. Oh, I thought I had safe cracking, or maybe I have lock picking. Yeah, I have lockpicking. Which is in here. Yeah, lockpicking. I don't have the other one. That's a bummer. Oh, you know what? I have not been upgrading these skills. Because it looks like I have some expertise to spend. Though it doesn't actually say that anywhere, does it? And again, I'm not sure what I actually want to do with it, though, because, I don't need, I'm doing just fine with the combat, so I'm not inclined to do too much here. Hellbender. Outfoxing. You're smarter than a box of rocks. Yeah, see, it doesn't say what it does, so, I can pick extremely complex locks. I mean, that'd be cool, but I don't have that much XP. I'm gonna wait on that, but I'm curious how to get Safecracking now. What about this one? You hear the sounds of several goblins snoring inside the tent. Yeah, let's go in guns blazing. I think I can take them. Alright, let's attack. Oh, actually, I want to do, my Bean Golem. This is the combat system in West of Loathing. It is, tactical RPG? I don't know. What is the turn-based RPG? Maybe that's the right one. Like the Final Fantasy style. You have your skills alongside here. You have your items that you can do, and you just select what you want to do. Now, you have action points, which it tells you somewhere, but I can't quite figure out exactly where it shows that. So it tells you exactly where your action point... It tells you how many action points you have. I used all of them for the Bean Golem. But I can still attack every turn, in addition to what I did for the what I did for that. So I can pick from these two. I'm gonna use the pistol because there's no such thing as ammo, and it has more damage, basically. Oh, I should have thought about which one of these I wanted to attack, but I think it's okay. So, I could do 3 hot damage, or I can give someone a pep talk, raising the stats by 2. I'm inclined to, rather than, you know, deal measly, like, 3 damage, I'm gonna talk to the bean. I'm gonna give the bean reassurance. Let's bark at the moon. Ow. Come on, beanie. Nice. That's what I want to see. So I have no more action points. They don't recover during the battle. So I have no way to do any other spells, unfortunately. So I just need to shoot. And I don't think there's much good in actually like reassuring more than once. Pretty sure it's already reassured. I wonder if it stacks? I actually have no idea. Let's try again. I don't know. It looks like it went up again. So we'll see what happens with that. I really wish the bean I could control the bean so I could focus fire, but that does not appear to be a thing. Okay, in this case, I think I can take him with a bash. Oh wow, 6 HP. It said 3 earlier. Beat! No! It's okay. He'll be fine. You heroically defeated the sleeping goblins who are guarding their beds. You gain 30 XP. This footlocker is empty. Unlocked footlocker. I guess that means it's just a footer? Chemical bullets and more military grade whiskey. I'm curious what this chemical bullet is. In addition to lead, this bullet is made with substances that is highly poisonous when it gets into your blood. Hmm. Interesting. This is a special kind of government whiskey designed for soldiers in the field. It's fortified with all sorts of vitamins and things that can be used in a pinch to sterilize, or at least make the victim feel better about, a battle wound. Huh. This footlocker is still locked. Oh, I don't have a needle, though. The lock on this footlocker has rusted away to almost nothing. A silver bullet. I bet that has to do with, like, werewolves or something, right? against cows and other demonic creatures. Yep. Yeah, that's the whole thing. It hasn't went into a lot of depth about what cows are in this game, but they definitely do seem to be demonic. Some sort of a plague, plaguing the earth in the West. It's referred to the cows coming home several times, as being a, like, apocalyptic sort of event. Cool. Well, I don't have a needle, so I even though I have lockpicking, I still can't pick that lock. So, that's a bummer. Huh. Oh well. I guess I'll go to the mess hall? Yeah, that's a mess hall, right? Stove is beyond cleaning. Blah. Okay. Ooh! Spice rack, yeah. Shaker of saltpeter. Okay. Yeah. Looks like there's still some good mess left. Let's take it. More military-grade whiskey and hardtack. Nice. Reception desk. Now, the most appropriate thing to receive would be a free trip to the dump. This cabinet is mostly empty, but there are a handful of boring personnel records in the back of one drawer. Let's examine it. They were incredibly boring. No, really, I want the details. Fine, you read one. Charles Stern, clerk. Pay grade C4. Accrued sick days 88. No, another! Becky Smith. Accrued sick days 0. Oh, wow. That's quite the flip. No, another! Killed in action. Oh. Build another. Okay. Wounded in action. No, another! Wow, I have no option, by the way. It's the only thing I can do. Good conduct medal. Fine, you read one. It's the same thing again. Now you're just looking at the same ones you've read before. What's wrong with you? I can't get enough. Maybe something will happen if I do it again? No, does not appear that anything will happen. Okay, well, I guess I can click off to make it go away. In general, this is a door. More specifically, it's the door to the general's office. Even more specifically, it's the locked door to the general's office. Okay, so I need needles, ma'am. I wonder if I can get them back in town. Yeah, I need to go see if I can get into town, I suppose. Hey, Pete. What's going on? I would expect to see some soldiers marching around, seeing as how it's a fort and all. Oh yeah, we've already sort of talked about this. Hey, lethal juice. I want to go back to town. Because I need to get some, hopefully I can get some needles. Your keen eyes detect a secluded cave in the distance. Exploring it would definitely be a good use of your time. Shaggy dog cave. Let's check that out later. Oh, hey Pete, what's going on? The old Coal Ridge Mine ain't far, and if you've mind to check it out, what's it like? Never been, but sounds friendly type of place. Alright. Cool, man. Yeah, okay. No, let's leave. I did not mean to go in there. I need to go here to see if I can buy some needles. No, he doesn't have any needles. That's a real shame. Man, I wonder if there's somewhere I can get needles. Hey, you look nice. Hello? You? Hey, what's going on? Hey, stop! Oh, can't go that way. Well, I don't know. Alright, sorry about that. Quick muting got me to sneeze without sneezing on mic. Blowing out your eardrums. Hey little girl, I know you're trying to sell me flowers. I bought some already. Is that it? I guess so. Man, how do I get needles? I wonder. Can I buy them from him, maybe? Hey, Lloyd. I'll have a shot of bourbon. No. What's the deal with the piano player again? I know he's like a robot or something. Yeah, see, I need a needle for him too. I need 3 needles now. I have no idea how to get needles. Oh well, I mean, let's go to the closest mission over here. Your boo sense tells you you're in the presence of a rock. Wait, your boo sense alerts you to the presence of a rock. Confused, you move the rock, and sure enough, there's a bottle of booze behind it. Cheap tequila. Phew, you were afraid for a second that your boo sense had been replaced with some kind of rock sense. Okay, well, hey, Pete. Shaggy Dog Cave, that's a funny name. Seems to me I've heard tell of this place. Can't rightly recall the details, though. Guess we'll have to check it out. I always want to go look around before I go inside, too, because you never quite know. Also, these, like, piles of rocks makes me want to, like, see if there's anything to do. There's a plaque bolted to the cave wall here. A record of events of the expedition to and into Shiny Dog Cave. By Jim Blackwright. Okay. Well now, it seems some fellow was right enamored by the expository plaque. Think they're important? Won't let us know who needs to read them. Okay, I already did. Oh boy, another plaque. There's a plaque bolted to the cave wall here. Have acquired through various and sundry means, story which is interesting in its own right, but better saved for another time, a map purporting to lead to a large cache of jewels and ingots of precious metals hidden by the infamous highwayman and train robber Black Cole Jr. in the years before the cows came home. I, Jim Plackwright, along with the 3 compatriots, these being Nathaniel Wyman, Cyrus Howard, and Douglas Watts, are out to find the Shaggy Dog Cave and the aforementioned treasure. Huh. Oh boy. I'm probably not going to read all these. Like, I'll read them. I just gotta read it. I'm going to miss out on something if I don't. Our equipment and provisions consisted of 1 cart and a horse to pull it, 4 additional horses to be ridden, 2 shovels, a spade, a mining pick, a large coil of rope, a large basket of eggs, as well as an assortment of other trail provisions and cookware, my own collection of blank plaques and engraving tools, 1 large and shaggy dog, and a butt 4. I know the joke that's coming. I know the joke that's coming. You ready? You ready for it? Because it's in this last line, and a but for. You ready for this? It's gotta be this. Let's read it. After traveling for 2.5 days to the south and east, we arrived at a small town named Dirtwater, largest settlement in the vicinity of Shaggy Dog Cave. Leaving the dog to watch the horses, the 4 of us entered the local saloon and each ordered a beer, except Sai, who was satisfied with water. He didn't do the joke, though. Maybe it's too on the nose, but that's this game, this, loathing, of Kingdom of Loathing is very on the nose, though. Let's read it. The barman provided our drinks as requested and then withdrew a small wooden box from underneath the bar, asking us if we cared to witness something real interesting. Considering that we all still had quite a few hours left to travel, we politely declined and asked him if he knew the way to Shiny Dog Cave. He replied that he had never been there personally, but gave us rough directions, which correlated nicely to the notes on our map. If it doesn't actually, like, give the punchline to the joke, I'll come back and help you with that, if you didn't get it. Upon leaving the saloon, we discovered to our dismay that some unknown villain had tampered with our wagon. Fortunately, the only supplies missing were the butt 4 and the entire basket of eggs, apart from one that Doug had concealed within a pocket for safekeeping. We all discovered that the dog had absconded with one of our horses, forcing Nate and Sai, after drawing lots, to share. After acquiring a barrel of fresh water for the trip, as well as a replacement butt 4, We headed out to the open desert. The sun shone down mercilessly upon us, though we took a small solace in the fact that we would have been far more intolerable had we made this expedition during the summer months rather than November. In order to pass the time on the trip and resist becoming dazed from the heat and susceptible to desert mirages, we exchanged stories of our youth, which I will not be retelling here for reasons of length. Great. However, I will relate to you three odd occurrences that happened to us during our trek through the desert. The first two were 2 or 3 hours out of dirt water when Nate noticed a glint of sunlight upon a metallic object partially buried in the sand. This was revealed to be a brass oil lamp of foreign design and manufacture, which fortuitously still contained a quantity of oil. Deciding this might come in handy, we stashed it in our wagon with our tools. This is a rather large cave. There's a plaque. Our next encounter was with a nomadic goblin tribesman who we discovered spoke excellent English. It inquired as to our destination, and we told it the Shaggy Dog Cave, though we did not disclose the reason. The goblin confirmed that we were heading the correct course and mentioned that he had only a short time earlier witnessed a large and shaggy dog riding a horse in the same direction. We all agreed that this was an unusual sight and continued on our way. What is going on? Sometime later, we encountered a large adobe hut occupied by two identical seeming old men with wild hair and long white beards. They invited us to take shelter from the heat, which we gratefully accepted, and introduced themselves as hermits. This struck me as peculiar, given that there were two of them, but I felt it would be rude to question them at that point. One of the hermits confirmed that we were near Shaggy Dog Cave, and the other hermit confirmed that his brother said was true. They also commented that they had seen a large and shaggy dog riding a horse in that direction. We all agreed this was an unusual sight indeed. The hermits refreshed our water supply in exchange for our butt war, and we continued on our way, excited to finally be nearing our goal. After 2 more hours, we finally arrived at the Shaggy Dog Cave, carefully keeping our excitement in check, lest we become incautious. We unloaded our equipment and supplies from the wagon, and took a brief respite in the cool-shaped cave entrance. To celebrate our arrival, Doug unpocketed and shared the egg he had saved from our basket that had been stolen in dirt water. Once we rested, we decided the time had come to explore the cave. What are we doing here? Discovering that we had neglected to pack torches, lanterns, or any other light source with which to illuminate the cave, we declared that it was indeed fortuitous that Nate had discovered that antique oil lamp during our travels. He gave the brass a quick shine and then lit the wick, and we were relieved to discover that it lit easily and provided a very adequate amount of light. As we headed into the cave, we were further encouraged by the fact that the floor was quite even and easy to traverse, and there were no side passages which might cause us to become lost. Despite this, I resolved to hang a number of plaques to mark our progress through the cave and engrave them with the tale of our journey, such that others who discovered the cave after us might be entertained and edified by our story. Soon we came to the end of the tunnel. While Nate, Cy, and Doug took turns with the excavation, I completed the last of the aforementioned plaques. It was a matter of perhaps an hour before Cy's shovel struck a wooden surface with a hollow noise, and we hauled a traditionally styled treasure chest out of the hole with great excitement. There's the hole. The chest was locked with an ancient rusting iron padlock, which broke easily from a single swing of our pickaxe. We opened the lid slowly, and the flickering light of an antique oil lamp shone brilliantly upon jewels of every color and shining ingots of precious metals that, just as promised by the legends of Black Cole Jr. Joyous at our triumph, we loaded the chest into our wagon and began the journey home. Thank you for reading, and may your own endeavors be equally successful. Okay. It's a hole, completely empty. You know, I would not be surprised if this is all that there is to this. If this is the entire thing, and there's nothing to be gained from here at all. That is my guess. That is very Kingdom of Loathing. Anyway, the correct question to ask in the that after reading the inventory and getting into the, you know, but for is, what's a but for? And then I think you can come up with an answer yourself. It's pretty silly not to know what a but's for, though. Oh boy. Hey, Pete. I think we can get out of here. The aristocrats! What? Okay. Well, that was a waste of time. Let's go, Lethal Juice. Still don't have a needle, so I can't go to Fort Cowardice or do anything else there, so... Encounter an overturned wagon surrounded by ruined books and broken pairs of spectacles. Looks like the family of especially literate homesteaders met an untimely end here. An advanced bean craft? What? I can't stop, but, let's read that thing. To learn a bean slinging skill. There's a chapter about cooking beans dishes. Beans. There's a chapter about cooking bean dishes so small that they have to be served intravenously. Gives blood beans, a skill that lets you regenerate health during combat. There's a recipe for a well-shaped pile of beans that looks pretty interesting. Gives bean wall. I think I already have that one. And there's an article about butter, an article about beans, and a juxtaposition gives you an idea. Butterbean, a spell that reduces an opponent's muscle, mysticality, and moxie. I think I want to learn blood beans. Getting more health regen would be really great. You got skill blood beans. Regenerate 3 HP per round in combat. Cool. Unfortunately, you got so distracted by your newfound vigor that you misplaced the book. Aww. Alright, welcome to Manifest Destiny Railroad. Can I, like, get in or something? Hey, Pete. Woohoo! Look at all them rocks. This year the train ain't moving for a while. Wonder if we can help. City Slicker in the hat looks like the kind of fella to ask. Okay. There's someone in here. Inside that car, it seems. Hello? This guy should never be put in charge of a switch. Okay. He's too busy playing with his watch to get any work done. Ask him where he got it. Say, that's a nice watch. Where'd you get it? I bought it from this gal that runs the store down south of here named Button Willow. Button Willow Mick something. Where's the store exactly? Oh, you can't miss it. It's right between the cactus and a different cactus. Great. Button Willow's McKittrick's store. Huh. Mention it? No, really. Thanks a lot. Man furrows his brow. Sure. Don't mention it. Mention it. I mean it. I really appreciate you telling me where that store is. Really, it's no trouble at all. Don't mention it. I mean it. Mention it. I've run out of ways to thank you, but I really want to know that I'm really grateful for your help. No, do not mention it. He looks about ready to punch you if you don't knock it off. Okay, don't mention it. Hello, Whistler. She's not getting much track laid, but she's an expert whistler. Hello, City Slicker. You approach the beleaguered looking man with tiny glasses. Howdy there, who's in charge of this outfit? If I'm being charitable, I say the fellow over there in the white hat is the foreman. He points to the man next to the huge pile of rocks. And if you're not, then I'd say that paper-backed idiot over there with the absurd white hat is the fellow you're looking for. Alright. Oh, he looks really unhappy. Hi, are you in charge? I was wondering if there's anything I can do to help. You want to know something? I love trains. I love turtles. Ever since I was a little boy, huge, magnificent, roaring iron beasts. They were magical to me, like dragons. When the opportunity arose to take on management of this rail line, I jumped on it in a shot. You know what I learned? Organizing and building and running one of those operations is the most amazing pain you will ever imagine. You want some help? Congratulations, you're the new foreman. I'm going home to play with my models. Okay. Can I have your hat? Please? Okay. Hey, dude. Guess what? I guess I'm the boss now? Well, now, I suppose you can't be any worse than the last clown. Name's Smee. I'm your assistant. Well, I'm sure you didn't miss seeing this giant pile of rocks blocking our path. Surveyors say this isn't any... There isn't any other suitable mountain pass, so we can't reroute it around, even if we had the months it'd take. Well, by my calculations, we could dynamite and clear without too much trouble. Problem is, it'll take a lot of dynamite. A whole year's worth, I figure. We'd used to keep that much on hand for emergencies just in case, or just as this one, but pack of goblins stole it all. Sneaky little varmints. Fine, I'll get it back. Glad to hear it. The goblins are holed up over at Gustavsson Gulch. Gustavsson Gulch. It's a real tough place. You might want to spend some time getting the lay of the land and honing your fighting skills before you head that way. Especially if you plan to go in guns blazing. Okay. We don't need specific dynamite, though. If you can lay your hands on... Any you lay your hands on would be fine, as long as there's enough of it. I mean, I do have some dynamite. Any luck finding a year's supply of dynamite? No. But, I mean, I've done some dynamite. Can I, like, get on the train, though? The old screaming bison. Yep, the good old Cleveland Ram. Okay. Can I get in or something? Doesn't look like it. I don't know. I guess there's nothing else I could do here, so let's go. I think before I jump over there, though, I might circle back and do a couple other missions. Just like they said, they want me to level up, I bet. You crest a hill to see a skeleton propped up on his elbows looking through a pair of binoculars at the horizon. I guess he died before whatever he was waiting for showed up. Ooh, more binoculars. Yup. Wait a minute. I just saw a speech bubble over here. Was that left over from the train scene, perhaps? Hey, Pete. Another mine, eh? Reckon it'll come in and have a glance if you're reckoning on exploring it. Alright. Beer barrel cactus. Ooh. Sometimes you can get meat out of these, because apparently you mine meat out of the ground. Row of lockers must have been used for storing the personal effects of the fellers who used to work this mine. The first one is labeled Ellsbury Wim. It doesn't have a lock on it. The label on the second one is covered in some kind of white goo. The label on the third one is Loose Ben. Has a combination lock on it. Let's do the first one. Ellsbury helmet. Bottle of laudanum. Okay. Open the third locker? Yeah, I don't know the combo. What about the second one with the white stuff? You open the third door to reveal a skeleton covered in some white goo that was on the outside locker. Ah, you get it. The guy must have died after his coworkers played a prank on him, where they stuffed him in the locker and then filled it with shaving cream. I can't believe you dang jerks stuffed me into my locker and then filled it with shaving cream. I died from that, yelled the skeleton, confirming both your insight and his vengeful, murderous intent. Yeah, let's fight him. I feel pretty good about this fight. Let's summon our bean golem, and let's shoot the dude. Oh, he's pretty strong. Yeah, let's try to light him on fire. It was much more effective last time. Maybe he'll like take some burning damage or something. Ooh, that was not very effective though. Ouch. We may not make this fight. Oh man. We might not make this fight. What can we do? The target will get wet. I mean, he kind of already looks wet. Can of kerosene. Making it flammable. I mean, I don't really want to waste it, but, call for match. Heal 10 HP. Man, I don't know. I don't really want to use my items because I'm concerned that it will not do as much as I would like, you know? So maybe what I'll do is I'll try to boost the bean. Bald-headed raccoon. Okay, it seems pretty good. Let's shoot. Let's reassure me this time. Boondoggled Widow. Uh-oh. See you, Pete. Yeah, maybe between the two of us we can take it. I wish there was something I could do to make Pete stronger, like give him better equipment or something. Doesn't seem like there is at the moment, though. We got it. Victory. Only 15. We got like 20 or 30 last time. At least he's not suffering anymore, and his bones are really clean. Ooh, I got a skeleton bone and bone chips and a handful of loose teeth. Ew. Why do I want that? Yeah, I don't know why I want any of those things. I could sell them to a dental student? Some itty-bitty bits of skull, once they're good for keeping somebody's brain cells inside. Yeah, but not anymore. Yeah. You don't have a bone to pick, but you do have a bone. Okay. Let's loot the cart. Get some meat. And 5 XP. Yeah. Alright. Ooh, and a meat vein. Let's mine that too. Oh, nice. We got unrefined meat nugget. And then Pete Elt, get some more. Cool. Okay. Whoa, this just opens into a 30-foot shaft. You're gonna need a rope or something. Don't I have a rope? I guess maybe not. Okay, well, I need a rope, and I need 3 needles to do things. Let's go, Lethal Juice. I guess let's go to the Big Apple. Pete stops, spots something on the ground and picks it up. He spits on it and gives it a polish on his sleeve. Well, looky there. Find something? It's a lump of assholite. It's what they call jerk's gold. Like fool's gold? Similar, except it's poisonous. He throws the rock away and washes his hand with his canteen. Pete has grown stronger. What? That doesn't make any sense, but okay. This is exactly what I was hoping for. As you reach the center of the clearing, you are simultaneously stuck with a profound awe and a terrible stench as you discover the largest road apple you've ever seen. You can't even imagine how it got there. Was it a giant horse? Was it 100 normal-sized horses acting collaboratively? They could have sent a poet. Yeah. Doesn't smell any better up close. Well, let's clean it up. Let's get 1 XP for every time I keep cleaning it. Okay. That was some XP. I don't even know how much XP it was, but you know, that was not bad. I don't mind that. Doc? If you're looking for exercise, imagine you could find more returning ways. Yeah, okay. Let's go, Lethal Juice. To the rescue mission. You find a liquor cabinet standing in the woods. Maybe there used to be a house around it. You try opening it and find it to be locked. That's probably why it didn't get stolen by whoever stole the walls. Another needle. Man, that sucks. Wish I had a needle. It's a little cluster of gin blossoms. Ooh. Hey, Pete. What's up, man? There's a mine in these parts I worked at for a bit. I'm only telling you so you can steer clear, though. Why? It just ain't no good. Lost Dutch oven mine. Yeah, you know what? Yeah, I, think we want to go check it out. I mean, we got to, right? The pulpit has been pushed back against the wall. There's a haphazard stack of pews in the corner. Can I loot anything? Medical supplies? No. Gosh, a real-life nun. Yes, I'm Sister Tabitha. I'm Felix Cassidy. What's with the cots? Well, what's with the cow attacks and so... What with the cow attacks and so on? I have felt my faith would be better served by running this place as a clinic rather than just a church. I also sell medical supplies if you're, like, you're healing to go. Do you need any errands or anything? Funny you should ask. I've been experimenting with the healing properties of purple grass that grows near here, but I've run out. Would you mind picking some for me? It grows near a cave that makes an unusual humming sound. Cool. Not yet. Yeah, I'll get it, man. Don't worry about it. Can I buy some medical supplies? I would like a broken leg pill. You're not sure which is stranger, that these work at all, or that they only work on legs. Cool. Let's go complete her mission, I suppose. The humming cave up here. He picks up a round rock the size of a tennis ball. Aha! Geode! A who? You know them, vending machines with all little capsules in them, and toys and capsules. This is that, but all natural. He pulls a rock hammer out of his belt and cracks the geode open. Inside is a little rubber finger puppet. Hehe, nice. Pete has grown stronger again. Nice. That's great. I wish I could, like, see his stats, but I can't at all. Which is unfortunate, but it's fun. Does this happen automatically? Your bloodstream is chock full of tiny beans, which are in turn chock full of restorative... Oh, that happens automatically. Oh, wow. I mean, I thought it was a spell that I would have to cast, but if that's automatic, that is... seems really, really strong. Cool. Oh, these rocks are weirdly organized, indeed. This must be what the nun was talking about. Okay. Well, I kind of have to go check it out. Humming cave. Kind of surprised I don't hear anything, considering... I might be able to push this over. 10 muscle, eh? What do I have right now? I have 5 muscle. So, what I could do... I could give myself more muscle. I don't mind doing at least one more. It gives me 6. And then I could do, items. Some of these things will give me bonus muscle. Oh, can I put this on? 2 armor versus... I think I'd rather have this, though. I didn't realize I could click on this to get more information. So 5 to 7. No, that's the best one I got. Sweet smelling flowers. Give me stench resistance. And that'll give me... Ooh, this will give me more muscle, so I can equip that. Here. That puts me up to 7 muscle. No low pants and no boots. Take a look at armor, nope. Cheap tequila, nope. Hard tech, nope. Whiskey. Yeah, I could do that. I'd have to drink 3 more. I have 4. That's doable, but let's keep reading. Cheap wine. Cheap whiskey. Here we go. That's what I want. That puts me up to 10. You drink the cheap whiskey, it reminds you of college. College, rather, your buddy from grade school who died of cirrhosis. Grade school, Kansas, where you once spent a summer camp. Yelp. You can gain an effect, whiskey machismo. What is that? Whiskey machismo. Where is that mentioned? I don't actually see it. Hmm. Felix Sneaky Cassidy. Stomach, liver, spleen? Oh, how many alcoholic drinks you can handle. Oh, interesting, okay. Oh, stomach capacity is how many food items you can eat. Interesting, I didn't realize that was how that worked. How many potions you can use in a day. Okay. It doesn't mention anything about the whiskey thing, though. Let's push it over. Heave-ho! That ought to keep the snake at bay. Cool. Ooh, what is that thing? Indeed. Oops, I didn't mean to pass through it again. We are now in the bizarre ruin. What is that? The monolith is dark. It looks like there is a huge cave in at some point. A weird device. Strange stone arrow. This is a triangular object made out of strange stone-like material, shot through with channels of smooth black glass. I wonder if I can insert that into, like, the monolith or something. Doesn't look like it. Oh, here it is. Whiskey machismo. You're all liquored up and ready to punch something. Yeah, extra strength, or extra muscle. Okay. So, what do I do? Can I, like, equip it anywhere? Looks like no. I don't know. Doesn't look like I can do anything with it. So, I don't think there's anything else I can do here, which is weird. I'll continue, I suppose. Yeah, I can't go any further that way. I guess let's exit. Alright, and still, what's up with these rocks? Hey Pete, you know anything? You're looking pale. I ain't going in there. Is that sort of high-pitched buzzing noise? I hear it too. My head's about to burst. Hurry up and let's be in our way. Huh, it doesn't be that bad. Alright, well, I think we're done here. So, let's go back to the mission. Strange stone arrow you found starts going crazy, beeping and booping and whirling around its own accord. It practically drags you in the direction of a strange, decrepit-looking house. Let's check out the house. Oh, it's way down there, though. I don't want to go that far. Beeping machine leads you to a ramshackle house. I think next time I'm going to have to keep that in mind and, like, continue to where I'm going. And then I can decide if I want to go back. Loot the room first. Professor's toilet isn't in very good repair. Hey, I got 1 XP for flushing the toilet. This appears to be an extremely powerful magnifying mirror. It's basically inside-out microscope. The microscopic mites that live in your eyelashes seem to be getting along just fine. Okay. These books are so boring, you wonder if the shelf is in full of holes. Map annotated with circles and lines. This device doesn't seem to be operational unless its function is to do nothing. It looks similar to what we had back in that cave. Dresser contains 10 instances of the exact same shirt and 20 identical socks. That's minorly convenient. Doesn't look like this guy sleeps much. Hey, partner. Pete squints at the house's contaminant suspiciously, but doesn't say anything. Let's talk to him. Excuse me, my name is Felix Cassidy. What? Oh, didn't notice you come in. I'm not used to visitors, but folks generally call me the Professor. Is there something I can do for you? Well, I found this beeping gizmo and I sort of followed the beeping. Let me hear. Well, I'll be. It certainly led you to the right place, young man. This is El Vibrato technology, and I happen to be as much an expert as anyone alive today. El Vibrato, It's where the ancient race... They were an ancient race that lived here long before humans. Well, they mostly lived underground, so they might still be living as far as I know. Never seen a peep of actual person, though, just the machines they left behind. Were they space aliens? Could be aliens, or genius pre-humans, or entirely different terrestrial evolutionary line. At this stage of investigation, it's impossible to say. Isn't that exciting? Here, let me have a closer look at your beeping gizmo. Aha! As I suspected, this is one of their transponders. It detects other El Vibrato technology and homes in. You see, that's why it led you here. I've got this thing I'm trying to repair. He tinkers around with it for a bit and plugs in a strange stone marble into the socket. There you go, good as new. Just swipe up or down to turn it on or off. Swipe? Now I gotta warn you, this device will lead you to an abandoned El Vibrato technology, but it might just attract unwanted attention. From El Vibrato technology, you'll see what I mean, just be careful. Okay. You know, now that I think about it, you've arrived at a perfect time. In order to get anywhere further with my research, I need more samples. But searching for it eats up all the time I could be using to research it. Haha. Right? You're the adventuresome type, so bring back whatever devices you find, and I can get them up and running. That'll benefit us both. Great. First priority will be to get my keystone fabricator running. They locked their doors and things with these little stone alloy blocks. So if we can make our own, that'll open a lot of doors for us, literally and figuratively. What do we need? The components aren't rare, but at least as far as priceless ancient technology goes. Bring me about 5 handfuls of scrap. I should be able to salvage the last parts I need from that much. Okay. Well, I guess we can be on the lookout. Now, do we have to activate this thing? The professor says that this device calls out to other machinery. Examine it. Do you want to shut it down? No, let's keep it going. Let's go, Lethal Juice. We gotta go back to the mission. Off the trail's shoulder, you see some ancient petroglyphs carved into rock. I don't have that much mysticality. And it's not giving me the opportunity to, like, boost my mysticality, unfortunately. So, oh well. Let's go in. Welcome back. Yes. 30 XP, thank you. Can I buy some medical supplies? Actually, I don't need any. So, let's get out of here. May as well go to the Lost Dutch Oven Mine, even though we said not to. A burly grizzled man in leather. Well, everything is busy peeling in the skin. Wait. A burly grizzled man in leather. Well, everything. So everything is grizzled? Is busy peeling the skin off of a no longer recognizable animal. He looks up at you and growls, brandishing his skinny knife as if to say, "Bother me and you'll be next." And then he says, "Bother me and you'll be next." Yeah, I got that. Show him your skinny knife. That's not a knife. This. Don't be stupid. They're both knives. So you're a skinner too, eh? Well, not professionally. It's a hobby, I guess. All right, come over here and watch close. I'll show you a couple tricks. Hey. Nice. You don't really understand the tricks, but they result in you getting some free skin, so you're happy. Infernal leather and rattlesnake skin. Ooh. This horrible cow skin still has some demonic sigils branded on it. You think the cows would have lost interest branding once they were no longer domesticated. Maybe it's like an ironic thing. Rattlesnake skin. You hope that none of the rattlesnake's kin come looking for it. This game. I can put it onto my hat and get 3 muscle. I mean, that's really cool. I already have something on my hat, though. Snakeskin hatband. Right? It's probably giving me moxie, would be my guess. Yeah, that's my guess. I'm not sure, though. So, it doesn't look like I can actually do anything with that at the moment. Or that. Apply to hat. Your hat's already got a hatband on it. Do you want to be the person who shows up at the party wearing multiple hatbands? I mean, Sure, yeah, I don't see why not, but no, I guess not. Hey, Pete, you didn't want to go here, right? Oh hell, no. I ain't going in there, you can't make me. Wait, Pete, it smells pretty bad, it's just a smell. I ain't talking about the spell, dagnabbit. Can't you hear it? The whispering? I hear it all the way down in my dag-burned guts. I worked here for a spell. Quit because the other fellas went funny in the head, always talking about a voice they heard whispering to him. Never heard it myself till now. You'll stay out of there if you know it's good for you. What's it saying? Can't make it out clear. Ain't nothing good, I reckon. Huh. Well, I'm gonna go in, unless I shouldn't. Wow, those are some stinky fissures. I can't get any closer, not with some stench resistance. Oh, okay, hey, I have some stench resistance. The flowers. The flowers. It's here. Yeah. Let's do the sweet smelling flowers. Let's put those on. Now I can, right? Right? The stench is still buried. Oh, okay, cool. I can get through it now. I'm gonna switch back now because I like the boost that I get from the other one. Filthy porcelain cow gives me what? Yeah, melee attack damage and spell damage. Ooh, more lockers. Unlabeled and unlocked. Miner's pants. Hey, I don't have any pants and a gas mask. Right? Okay. Let's definitely put miner's pants on. +2 armor. You can't wear these if you're over 18 feet tall because they'd be way too small for you. Yep. Gas mask. Ooh, -3 muscle and mask. Wow, that's terrible. This thing was hard to find. This thing was hard to see out of even before it was in a dusty mine for 15 years. That's terrible though. Why would I want this instead of whatever I had? It's a hat, I guess. But still, that's terrible compared to the other one. Anyway, I guess I don't need to wear it. Miners must have eaten down here to avoid the stench upstairs. Grab what's left. Soda crackers and cat's eye candy. Increase your spell damage by 3. Soda crackers increase speed by 1. Ooh, a spittoon. Love spittoons. I don't know what kind of tobacco these miners are chewing, but it must have been extra corrosive because the brass spittoon has a hole through the bottom and dark stains underneath where the spit leaked out. Although oddly, it doesn't seem to be leaking now and it's half full. I guess the miners plugged the hole with something. Let's inspect it. It's a spittoon. It's disgusting. You can practically see the stink lines coming off it. Come on, let's not do this. No, let's inspect it. Ah, geez. Fine. Okay. You crouch down and take a careful look at the filthy spittoon. The inside is blackened with years' worth of stains. The death broth inside has a rainbow sheen like parking lot oil spill. And occasionally, a little bubble pops on the surface. You can actually feel a slight warmth radiating off of it from whenever the dire chemical reaction is taking place in there. You realize you're holding your breath, not deliberately, but from the human body's natural instinct for self-preservation. Inhale. Imagine someone made a big pot of chili con carne, left it under the porch. 3 rats crawl into the pot, eat half the chili, and then die. A week later, a family of cockroaches takes up residence among the withering maggots. The cockroaches smoke thick black cigars, with which they light with tufts of burning human hair. That's what it smells like. Search! Fortunately for you, the rainbow-colored film on the surface of the liquid coats your hand as you plunge it into the toxic stew, keeping it from being immediately dissolved down to the bones. The smell intensifies, and your stomach prepares to hose the poisons off of your arm. With high-pressure stream of vomit. Keep searching. Your fingers touch something at the bottom of the spittoon. Better pull it out fast, but you still have something to pull with. You pull in the world's most disgusting pair of pants. Out of the spittoon and jump back as the hole in the spittoon's bottom, now unplugged, begins to leak steaming filth. Congratulations, you're now the proud owner of the worst object I've ever paid to think about, narrowly defeating a leather bondage harness made from the skin of a clown. What? Wow. Spit-soaked pants. Well, hey, now we have 2 pairs of pants, suddenly. This one gives 2 armor. This one gives armor and speed, somehow. These pants look and smell like they've used to line the bottom of a leaky spittoon, and there's a very good reason for them. Yeah, let's wear them. Obviously. Creative mining supplies. Melling salts, thermos of spiked coffee, and a sulfur match. That's great. Anything else we can get in here? Elevator. Yeah, let's oil it. You lubricate the elevator liberally. Let's ride it down. You emerge from the elevator into a deeper shaft. By the light of your lantern, you see exposed meat veins on nearly every surface. It's unusual there'd be this much readily available meat left in a working mine. What were they digging for, if not this? Well, hey, I'll dig for it. Pete is not here, so Pete should not be pointing out meat that I missed, but we'll overlook it. And we're just gonna get all this. Let's ignore that guy and just get all the meat. Priorities, man, priorities. What is this? Shovels. A broken pickaxe. Is that back there? Ominous ladder leading down to a deep, dark pit. Looks like a miner died trying to dig deeper with their hands. Okay, let's go back and talk to this dude. Hey? This guy's totally out of it. He's gibbering and drooling. Doesn't even seem to see you. Try to talk to him. Hey, buddy, are you okay? Uh-huh. You wave your hand in front of his face and he doesn't react at all. Okay. Interesting. Well, let's go down. Ooh, what is that? The gem is pretty, but it smells terrible. An fulvorous emerald. 500 meat. Wow, this gem is half as valuable as it is pungent. You're in the money, and you should probably wash your hands before you spend it. Okay, more bones. This guy seems to have gnawed off his own hands before he died. The finger bones are all splintered. Your heart is pounding. There's still some little bits of fingernail in these gouges. You have to get out of this pit right now. Well, I don't want to. I want to know what's happening. This guy worked his fingers to the bone, digging, and then worked his bones to the marrow. You have to get out of this pit right now. These scratches are painted on in blood. You have to get out of this pit right now. These gouge marks are dark with blood. You have to get out of this pit right now. As you get to the near the rocks, the voices in your head begin screaming too loudly to ignore. You have to get out of the pit right now. Ugh, fine. But is there, like, nothing I can do here for real? I'd be a little disappointed if there's no, like, mystery. If there's no, like, something I can do. It's also a bummer I can't save that guy. Alright, well, let's mosey on out of here, I suppose. We got some good loot, including a couple pairs of pants, so that's good at least. Hey, Pete. Yeah, it's just the same message as before. Alright, well, what do we do? Let's skip this for now, because that's the storyline mission. Let's go here to the store. Maybe they'll have some needles so we can start to pick some things. Buttonwillow McKittrix. The woman behind the counter stares at you with a huge grin on her face. She gestures at the goods she's got for sale. Okay, I'll take a look. Advanced Beancraft. That sounds great. Let's check out what else we got, though. Do we have any more oil? We used a can of oil just now at that mine shaft. Definitely want to get another one if I do not have one anymore. Looks like I do not. So let's definitely buy one more can of oil, just in case. Desert eating and drinking. Oh, gives me foraging. Yes. How much meat do I have? I might have to sell some stuff for them. Disposable binoculars. Hammer. I don't have a hammer either. Man, there's gonna be so many expensive things I need to buy. Here we go. Oh, there's only one though? So lame. It's padlock at its name because it's like a wizard that protects your house. Yeah. Somebody clued me on that one earlier. Man, I want the hammer. Because it will do me... I'll be able to do something with it later, obviously, you know? But foraging... I don't know what I get for foraging. It might just be food items, in which case I'm not so interested. But I think what I'll do is I'll take another can of oil, I'll take the bean craft. Do I have enough to get the hammer? I do. I'd love to get the foraging, but I don't think I will bother. I could sell some stuff, but let's see how much meat we have. Okay, 670 meat. And I need 1,500 to get to there. That's going to take a while. I think I might just not worry about it. I can come back for that later. In the meantime, though, let's read Advanced Beancraft. There's a recipe for a wall-shaped pile of beans. Already got that. There's a whole set of recipes for ice-cold bean-based desserts. Great Northern Blizzard. A spell which deals cold damage to all of your enemies. And then there's a poem inscribed into the margins whose words keep shifting and changing, gives Uncanny Presence a perk that provides resistance against elemental damage. Hey, that sounds wonderful. Let's do that one. I like perks that I don't have to spend the thingies on, my action points. So I briefly lose consciousness, and I get resistance to a bunch of stuff. When you come to, you look at the margins of the book and see that the poem has been replaced with a crude drawing of you. Horrified, you destroy the book. Just in case. Fair enough. Alright. Do I still have some cheap whiskey? Because that is what I use to boost my strength. And I don't see any. It might be good to have some of that in case I need extra strength in the future. Little expensive, but I'll take it anyway. I have cheap tequila, I know. I'm pretty sure I have cheap wine as well. Let's double check that though. Laudanum. Oil. I definitely have tequila and whiskey and wine. Okay. So yeah, I'm fine. Yep. I still have no idea what a lock is for. I have no idea. Maybe for that reason I should buy one. Like, it's not that much. And who knows what I'll use it for, but it'll probably come in handy right when I need it. Cool. Well, that was super helpful. I'm going to have to come back to him or this person later because obviously that's... maybe they'll sell more needles later. You spot a small cottage on the horizon which looks like a work table in front of it. You discovered a new map location, Silversmith's House. Oh, that's on the way. Well, see, that's one where I would have stopped, but I couldn't, but oh well. Let's go help this dude, man. Guy looks like he's in a lot of pain. Oh, hello, were you able to get me some broken leg pills? Without them, I'm just sort of laying here in the street. Yep, here you go. Aw, thanks. I feel like a new man again, or at least the same man with a new leg. That's good, go drink some milk or something, okay? Well, that was nice. Yeah, should I, like, let's go check on the mail. Maybe I got something new for my family. Nope. Okay. Isn't there something else I was supposed to do here? I don't know, maybe not. Yeah. I don't know, I don't think there's anything else for me to do here. So, I guess let's look at the map one more time. I might call it here for the night. Getting a little late, gotta get up early to take the kids to school. Or, not take them to school, but get them ready for school. So, we're in Dirtwater. It's where I want to be. I have this silversmith's house we can check out next time, and then we also have the Gustafsson Gulch, which will be the mission progression. Not sure what else. I don't think there's anything else to do, so I think we're going to call it here. Thank you, everyone, who kind of joined me for the stream. I hope that you enjoyed the video. We'll be moving on to part 3 probably next week. I'm going to be doing this about every Sunday. And whether I stream over on Twitch or on YouTube, I will be uploading the videos to YouTube directly. So you can always watch them later if you don't watch them live. But check back here next week. We'll be back on Saturday, either here on YouTube or over on Twitch, twitch.tv/UnrealNighthawk. And I look forward to talking to you again next time. Don't forget to like and subscribe, because that's what all the YouTubers say we should do. Really, all that it means is if you want to support the channel, if you want to show some love, if you enjoyed the video, it helps other people find me. And I'm a pretty new YouTuber, so I'd really appreciate that if you liked it. Also, comments are welcome. I'll be happy to leave replies later on. But thanks, everyone. Hope you enjoyed the stream, and I'll talk to you next time. Bye-bye.